coming to the calculation part, this is a critical field resistance line, this is a shunt field resistance line. So we are making already points A, B, C, D here. This is a shunt field resistance. How you drawn means the saturated line, make point, then 0 point, then make use the scale, you can make triangle. After that, you need to find a critical field resistance. Resistance is nothing but simply according to Ohm's law, V is equal to V by I. V is equal to R means V by I. So from this critical field resistance line, you need to join this line, which will join this. Whenever this A point is touching C, mean this is a generated voltage. It means C. It means AC. Understood? So how much the voltage here? OC. OC. By how much current here? OB. OC by OB means OC by OB means it gives the slope of this critical field resistance. It's nothing but if it is understanding it's a 230, it's a 200 volts means 200 volts. Understanding here it's 200 by some ampere current 0.2. This means something will be there, 400 ohms like that will come. It means that this line slope is nothing but critical field resistance. What is meant by critical field resistance means this is the resistance above which the generator fails to build up the generated voltage. So you need to operate, you need to take the field resistance less than the critical field resistance. Means field resistance RF is less than the critical field resistance. Then only the motor will, the generator will generate some voltage above which it cannot be. That means of critical field resistance. It means, understanding example, more than what you can call it is more than 400 ohms of field resistance of the generator, the motor will not be generated the voltage. Okay. Then if you go for critical speed calculation, critical speed means NC unit. It means critical speed means this is the minimum speed below which the generator will not be generated voltage. It means we need to operate the motor more than the critical speed value. More than the critical speed value. It means how much the minimum speed is required to generate generated voltage of a generator, that we need to find by using this conductor experiment. So from the diagram we need to calculate. NC by NRPM is nothing but NC, critical speed by speed of RPM, is nothing but this BE by this voltage by total voltage AB. Small voltage by total voltage. So NC, the critical speed before, is nothing but BE. If it is some 20 volts, total means some 100 volts into RPM, NRPM. So 20 by 100 into before RPM, what is the motor means 1500 RPM. This 100 into 100 will cancel, means 1500 means 230, 300. What is the critical speed? 300. This is the example calculation of what I have said. It means if you wanted to generate a voltage, means minimum 300 RPM the generator has to be rotated. More than 300 the generator start building the voltage. Otherwise you are rotating generator by using this motor shaft is less than 300, means the voltmeter will not show the reading. Before the 15 volts it shows, it means more than the 300 RPM the generator is being rotating. That we need to understand. This is the calculation we done. So we have completed our experiment. The experiment is once I repeat. The magnitude we can say this is shunt generator. From this we drawn the graph. After this we are calculated critical field resistance, critical field. The purpose of this experiment, we need to find the critical field resistance and critical speed. And we need to understand how the OCC will be there. How the critical field is, how the RFC will be there. You know, how the voltage is generating here. We have drawn the right ascending order, the keep on increasing the field current, the armature current, how is increasing. Then decreasing the field current and how the armature voltage is decreasing. Initially it is a 15 volts. If it is descending order case, the graph drawn the descending order case like this, it will be more than the 15 volts. Some voltage will be left in the generator terminal. That voltage is called a residual voltage. That flux is called a, due to the residual flux, some voltage will be generated in that. It will be there and keep across the generator. It means some voltage will be there still. That called a residual magnetism voltage. That is what's the understanding of this experiment. This is a complete experiment. Here one is armature terminal, field terminal, this resistance terminal. This is the armature terminal, this is the field terminal. This is a three-phase supply differential oxygen. This is TPS switch, three-point starter. This is rear shorts, meter and voltmeter. This is, here we are using two, this side means EMC, moving coil wise we are using here. This is also like this. DC supply means we need to use moving coil.
Thank you for watching. Thank you. Bye.